My name is Nathan Daniel Phillips. I'm 17 years old, and I recently transferred here to North City Vocational Collegiate Institute for Studies in the Technological Arts. I'm running to be your new vice president, and my God, am I qualified. I've got an honor roll in every grade since kindergarten. I've received many academic commendations throughout my career, including academic achievement, literary excellence, distinction in arithmetic, French, and the Citizenship Award, whatever that is. At my old school, I was a frequenter of debate club, aviation club, chess club, bridge club, Model UN, and knitting club. I have good organizational skills, and I'm a fast learner. I'm a good team player, and I'm highly proficient with Microsoft Word and Excel. I think I'd be a great vice president, and when the time comes, I hope you make the right decision.
So, Ned, what did you think? It might have come off as a bit braggy, but do you think that's okay?
No, I mean, it was well put together, but you know you seem like an asshole, right?
Maybe this was a bad idea. I just need to get involved somehow.
No, I mean, you're definitely the most qualified candidate. Why don't we do it together? I'll be your campaign manager.
Elections here get a little out of hand sometimes.
Okay.
That's my friend Ned. I've known him since preschool. He's one of the reasons I came to North City Vocational Collegiate Institute for Studies in the Technological Arts. In grade 9, he came here and I went somewhere else. But thankfully our schools were close enough for our friendship to survive. I guess he's my campaign manager now, and there are only two people standing in our way. That's Libby Earle. She's all about political correctness, and she's like an 8th-wave feminist. Ned said she once punched her history teacher for calling it mankind instead of peoplekind. The school board tried to expel her, but she called them sexist, so they fired the teacher. The other guy is Jack Torrey. He's been my nemesis since I first met him in kindergarten.
Fuck off!
I probably didn't say that at the time, but the sentiment was there. I hate him with every fiber of my being, and I know he feels the same. He's literally the worst. I hate him. I want to impale him with a metal pole. I want him to survive a horrible stabbing, but not a small car collision on the way to the hospital. I want to bring him to the edge of death by strangling him in my basement, yeah. Then bring him outside to see the light of day one last time before I kill him.
What do you want?
I was wondering if you were excited for the assembly.
Oh, I'm excited. I'm so ready. The most ready. Are you ready, Jack?
Yeah, I have a friend who can do posters really, really well, so, like, if you need any help with that. I just don't want you to get swamped up with these elections. I mean, elections here get a little out of hand sometimes.
Shut up! I don't need your charity, Jack!
I'll see you there, then.
Seen the paper?
Yeah. Look at this shit.
Nathan Daniel Phillips cheated on third grade math test?
Nathan Daniel Phillips' dad secretly rich oil tycoon? He's just a lawyer.
North City Vocational Collegiate Institute for the Technological Arts wins gold medal at curling.
Oh, nice.
Nathan Daniel Phillips confirmed to be bad person?
Well, that's entirely subjective.
Who wrote this shit? Son of a bitch!
What?
What the fuck is this shit?
It's called journalism, and watch your language.
This isn't journalism, this is slander.
Freedom of speech, bitch.
This is ridiculous. What are you trying to accomplish with this? What are you doing? And watch your language.
Okay, as I see it, you have a few options. One, you could drop out of the race and avoid this controversy altogether.
I'm not doing that.
Or you could just kill yourself.
I'm not doing that either.
Mm-hmm. Looks like you're all out of options.
Just fuck off, stay out of my way.
So, do you, think I should drop out?
As your campaign manager, I'd have to advise against that.
I don't know, it's just not going the way I was thinking. I was hoping for this to be a way for me to get exposure, be involved in the school somehow, but I think people are gonna end up hating me more than liking me.
Well, I'm sure they're gonna like you. Compared to the other candidates, you're basically a saint.
Thanks, man, I guess.
Do you wanna watch election again?
Sure.
Yo, bitch.
Emperor, I fear someone has been sent to kill you.
Preposterous. I am too well loved and respected in this community.
Emperor, behind you!
Ah! Oh!
Murder!
I am slave!
Murder!
I am slave!
Oh my fuck!
What the fuck? What are you doing?
doing? Who are you?
I'm Green Party, and I'm running against you for VP.
You are?
Yeah.
What the fuck is this? Is this chloroform?
Yeah, I was trying to assassinate you.
Jesus Christ, why is everyone taking this so seriously? It's just some dumb election.
That's just how we do things here.
Are you guys done? We have a permit until 5:30.
Yeah, whatever.
Hey!
Out in the country, far from
home. Hey, Nate. What do you want, Jack?
You okay after last night, or you're a little shaken up?
Just stay out of my way, Jack.
You know, it's not kindergarten anymore. We don't need to hate each other. I'm just trying to help you.
You know what, Jack? There's something I've been meaning to tell you. Something I've wanted to say for a very, very long time. What the fuck?
Okay, see you, man.
Sorry, Nate.
Why would you do this? Please tell me someone else set you up to this.
It was Libby. Libby Earl. You know, the other candidate running against you?
Yeah, I know who Libby is. Why would you do this?
We're kind of dating. I needed an excuse to hang out with you.
Oh my god, is this what this is all about? You never wanted to hang out with me, but now I know you were just gathering intel.
No, Nathan, but you can't just expect me to throw away everything else in my life to spend time with you, worshiping you. I've been here for 2 years. I have other friends. All you care about is this fucking race. And for what? Another point on your resume?
I knew we were growing apart, but I thought we were still friends. You were my only friend here. I thought I could count on you.
Nathan, I'm sorry. Nathan!
Hey, it's Nathan Daniel Phillips, one of your candidates for Vice President, and I'm making this video to share my side of the Libby Earl scandal.
Oh, hey, Nate.
Jack, what are you doing in my house?
I was looking for the physics notes.
We don't have physics together, Jack.
No, I was looking for the math notes.
We don't have math together, Jack.
I was...
Cut the shit! What are you doing in my house?
I was trying to find something incriminating on you.
Of course you are. Who isn't?
Look, Nate.
No, this isn't fun anymore. This isn't a game. You broke into my house for some stupid election for vice president. Vice fucking president. I mean, we're not even that important to the school. We just bang the fucking gavel at the Senate meetings. You don't get to look Nate me. My parents are asleep in the next room and you're right here breaking and entering. That's an actual crime, you know. I could fully have you arrested. And lucky enough for you, I caught it all on camera.
I'm so sorry, Nate.
Just get out of my house.
Okay.
So, thank you both for coming. Looks like it's just the two of you left. It's been a pretty average campaign. Nobody's been thrown down the smokestack. I mean, last year was crazy. Libby Earl was disqualified for vandalism, and the Bloc Québécois candidate withdrew from the campaign in the hopes of starting their own school, so good luck with that. The Animal Rights Party was suspended for animal abuse, and the Green Party attempted murder. So, either of you got anything to say to each other, or are we actually gonna have to settle this by vote?
What?
Well, look, I don't know how they did it at whatever collegiate institute, but here it's usually just the last man standing. So, we all good? All right, well,
wait!
I knew it.
I'm dropping out of the race.
Ooh. All right then, Nathan, see you around, kid. All right, so congratulations, I guess, Mr. Vice President. And since no one ran for president, I guess I'm on again.
Wait, what?
How'd it go?
Why do you care?
I broke up with Libby.
Why? Because she was having you commit political espionage?
Yeah, and also she was a bitch, but I'm tired of pushing people away, people like you. Everything just got really out of hand.
It's okay, I got caught up in it too. I'm sorry. Wanna go back to my place and watch some House of Cards?
No, I've had enough politics for 1 week.
Alright, Mario Kart it is.
So, crazy week, eh?
Oh, yeah.
I'm just glad it's over now.
I'm glad we're back to being best friends.
I'm also super happy we made it out alive.
Oh, you clearly haven't been here for prom. The best friend that I ever had. I've been with you such a long time. You're my sunshine, and I want you to know that my feelings are true. I really love you. Oh, you're my best friend. Oh, you make me
I'm sorry.